Hi, my name is David Hunter with the Dickson Company, and today we're on site at a customer smokehouse where we're going to show you the entire smoking process and how Dickson products fit within that entire application, and also help you to store and monitor that critical data to adhere to food safety standards and regulations. So follow me, let's check it out. The environmental conditions of the entire smokehouse are maintained at a constant level so that the facility adheres to food safety standards. The smoking process begins in these vats full of brine solution created of different spices. From there, the product will move over to the refrigeration unit. And here, depending on the product, it'll remain for 12 to 24 hours. And our SM325 units are perfect for monitoring this type of application. With its large display, you can easily monitor the temperature from the outside without opening and closing the refrigeration door. So here we are in the refrigerator, and it is a whopping 36 degrees, so I'm going to be fairly quick with this process. We have our immersion probe units. These are great for monitoring the actual temperature of the liquid, the brine, as the product sits and distills in there. Also, we offer the option of getting an HT200 unit, which is stainless steel and waterproof, and is perfect for food applications because you can place it directly within the liquids throughout the entire process. So once the food comes out of the refrigerator, it's placed on these racks here where it's prepared to be smoked. These racks go directly into that industrial-sized smoker, and the smoking process is complete. Our HT225 units are great for monitoring your products when it goes throughout its entire smoking process, especially when it's in a smoker and it needs to reach a critical temperature for a certain amount of time. All you need to do is simply place the probe into the product this way and then leave it while it sits in there throughout the entire process. And then once you're finished, you can download that data via the USB port to prove that it had reached the critical temperatures it needed to. So here we are at the second to last stage of the smoking process, which brings us to this large oven which does the smoking. A great unit to monitor the internal temperature is our SM325 probe unit, where you can run the probe in through the door and it monitors the area, and you can keep the door closed and monitor the internal temperature from the large display here, which also is logging that critical data. Also, you can place an HT200 unit inside of the smoker as well to keep that constant temperature monitoring. And also remember that you will have that HT225 probe unit inside the meat to get that core temperature of the meat throughout the smoking process. Once done, then the food comes back out into a temperature controlled room where it's cooled until it's ready to be cut and packaged. And there you have it. That's the entire smoking process.